11 minutes to 8, and tell us all about it. I'm speaking of traffic. Here's Lucy in the Sky.
Gold FM, up-to-the-minute traffic. Here's Lucy in the Sky.
Well, we've got very, very big problems in the southern suburbs at the moment. From a 2 kilometre radius around the intersection of the Nepean Highway and South Road, the lights are completely out, particularly through Hampton on South Road between East Boundary Road and Hampton Street, and also Beach Road and Hampton Street. So that whole area is a great big schmozzle at the moment. Be very, very careful if you're heading through there. Some good news now. City-bound traffic along Swan Street between Punt Road and the Yarra River has been reopened. I'm afraid traffic is building up right now. Southeastern Freeway is banking back almost to Toorak Road. The Westgate Freeway Bridge is looking pretty heavy at the Power Street exit at the moment. Very heavy in from Greve Parade. The Tullamarine Freeway is bad from Bell Street. The Eastern Freeway is almost back to the Yarra Boulevard. And the Nepean Highway, once you've cleared all that mess in Hampton, is very slow into town from Brighton. No speed cameras out there either. If you do see one, give us a ring on 9420 1111. And every day, the NRMA helps more Australians with their cars and homes than any other company. Call NRMA for HELP on 132 132. This is Lucy in the Sky, back with another Gold FM traffic update in 15 minutes.
And now, Lucy, just before you go.
Yep.
Can you see any snow anywhere up there?
No, well, actually, we've only just got off the ground, to be honest, Frank, because the tower wouldn't let us up there, so that was good that they're looking after us.
Were you when you did the 7:15 traffic report?
I was sitting in the hangar.
Well, how can you see that?
Well, how much traffic was in there, Luce?
Well, not a lot, actually. Just me back and forth to the kitchen getting a cup of tea. That's the only traffic I saw. It was a rare opportunity for me, but it was lovely. But I'm up here now, so...
Well, we did have a call from a listener from Spring Hill who said it was snowing at Spring Hill.
Oh, he can get a plastic garbage bag out and sit on his backside and go for a ski down the lawn or something.
And I'm just wondering if there's any of our other listeners are experiencing snow conditions anywhere in Melbourne or the immediate area. They should give us a bell and let us know. 9414 1043. Thanks, Lucy.
Bye.
This is Barry Brown of Calibre Collision Centres. If you're in a car accident that's not your fault, it's your legal right to choose your own repairer. Here's why you should. This is what a qualified engineer found after an insurance company repaired a car on the cheap because it wanted to save money. Hold on to your wallet. Poor paint match, grit in paint, poor panel fit, incorrectly installed parts, missing parts, hammer and chisel marks in the body, burnt carpet, poor welding, visible gaps in the floor and corrosion already established. That's just a sample. We don't have time to tell you everything that's wrong with this one-year-old Commodore, but here's the frightening part. He says, of major concern is the distinct possibility the vehicle may be structurally unsound owing to the poor repair techniques adopted. Think about that when you're driving your kids to school. Don't let an insurance company ruin your car and risk your family's safety. Call Calibre on 1300 654 399. We care about you and your car.
Calibre Collision Centres. The finest in collision repair.
Filth outside operating theatres. Third world conditions in the wards. This isn't Russia. It's happening right here in Melbourne. There's a crisis in our healthcare system. Channel 7's Today Tonight has the pictures exposing the appalling situation at a major Melbourne hospital. Someone you know could be the unwilling victim of these unsanitary conditions. When the hospital itself is sick, what chance do you have of a full recovery? A special report tonight at 6:30 on Channel 7's Today Tonight.
The Weekend Furniture Company needs your help.
Due to the Indonesian crisis and strikes on the wharf, the Weekend Furniture Company is stuck with 3 extra containers of genuine teak furniture.
2,000 pieces of top quality teak furniture will be auctioned at any cost.
Bid on genuine teak dining tables, chairs, veranda lounges, wardrobes, outdoor settings and more.
Planter boxes, folding chairs, kitchen cabinets, lime-washed benches and cabinets, couches and armchairs.
There are no reserves.
That's right, no reserves.
A table that retails for $1,500 could go for as little as $200. The Weekend Furniture Company auction.
This Sunday, 11 a.m. sharp, viewing from 9 o'clock, 51 Hague Street, Southbank, near the corner of Clarendon Street. See the auction section of Friday's Age for more details.
This is Barry Brown of Calibre Collision Centres. If your insurance company doesn't care enough about you to let you choose your own repairer, call Calibre on 1300 654 399 and we'll give you the names of companies that do.
The times and nothing but great songs.
Seven minutes to 8 o'clock.
And I just have to say very quickly, if Sam and Charlie aren't dressed yet, you better get dressed because you've got 7 minutes to get to school.
I'm open around.
It's about to be.
Good times are nothing but great songs from the 60s, 70s and 80s here on Gold FM, and that is one of the all-time great Australian bands, Daddy Cool.
Absolutely.
And good morning to Ross Hannaford and Wayne Duncan and Ross Wilson and Gary Young, who are all members of Daddy Cool and who are all good mates of mine and
you
who all listen
everything.
To the show. I don't know everything, but I do know something.
What's that?
On this day, ooh. Monday the 22nd of June, yes. In 1847...
Was it a Monday?
Something important. It was, well, probably not. But it was, something very important was invented. Now, I'll give you some hints, see if you can guess what it was. It is a staple part of our diet.
Mm.
It is...
I need a bigger hint than that.
It's got a big hole in it.
A bagel?
Close. No, the donut was invented.
A donut?
Yeah, it was invented in 1847.
Not in Australia, though, wasn't
well,
invented.
No, it's more an American thing, isn't
yes.
it?
Yes.
But it's sure to be gospel because it's in the Jocks Journal, which all the jockeys
yes.
get. And it's interesting that tea, it also says in the Jocks Journal, that tea was first drunk in England in 1650 on this day.
Really?
And, yeah, and then they had to wait till 1847 before the donut was invented so they had something to dunk in it.
Oh, no.
Your tea would be cold. It's 120 years.
And it'd be a bit elderly by then too, wouldn't it?
It would. And we've been delivered in here in honour of this magnificent occasion that the day the donut was invented.
Yes.
From Donut King, we've been delivered some magnificent donuts in here. I'll just get one out and see if
would you? Would you? Well, I love a good donut. Oh, and some of them have got icing on them
yeah.
too.
We've got the choc-coated ones with the little fairy tales on them. And
we've got the coffee-coated.
And the pineapple-coated and the strawberry-coated.
We're very excited.
And if you go down to Donut King, at Donut King in Melbourne Central, it's on level one. We have a couple of special offers for you today. The first 20 customers who mention Gold FM will receive one free cappuccino with their donut.
And how are they going to share that between 20 of them, though?
Well, that's going to be difficult. There'll be 20 straws, I suppose.
Oh, I see. Okay, fine.
And any office order placed with Donut King will receive a 10% discount if you mention Gold FM. So that's down at Donut King in Melbourne Central. Now, do you like donuts with your
I seriously
coffee?
Do, mm. yes. I'll be having a donut in a moment.
How do you think they got the name donut?
I have absolutely no idea. What I'd like to know is who was the first person who stuck his finger into something and then discovered that it had a hole in it? The donut I'm talking about.
I'd like to know what happens to the hole in the donut. That little bit of whatever the donut is made of. What happens?
They send them to places like hospitals and stuff like that.
They do not.
They do, seriously. And to food bank places, you know?
Is that true?
Yes, I think they do.
I never knew that. So there you go. Donut King today was the anniversary of the donut, and news is next.
Time magazine rated him the most influential folk musician of the last 100 years.
Come gather around, people, wherever you're on.
He is the master poet.
Don't think twice.
That changed the way a generation lived. He is Bob Dylan. And Gold FM is proud to present the legend in concert at Melbourne Park on Friday the 21st of August.
Pistol shots ring out in a barroom night.
Don't miss Bob Dylan live in concert.
Once upon a time, it didn't seem fine.
With special guest Patti Smith. Tickets go on sale Thursday, June 25 through Ticketmaster 136100. Bob Dylan. Proudly presented by Frontier Touring Company at 104.3 Gold FM.
What did you do in the war, Grandad?
Well, son, we were pinned down in the trenches by German flamethrowers. So you know what we did? We stuck golden crumpets on the end of our bayonets, and when the flames blasted over our ridge, we toasted the crumpets till they were golden brown. We had a warm winter snack at Jerry's expense. Those golden crumpets tasted so good, it was just like being at home.
Gee, Grandad, you're full of it.
Golden crumpets, golden good.
Hello, could I have the number of the Inner Self Float Tank Center? Hey, Jade, isn't it? Could you connect me straight through? Thanks.
Hello?
Hello, Inner Self. I'm in tank 205, and I'd love a cappuccino.
Vodafone Through Connect. Directory assistance that puts you straight through. Network Vodafone.
Oh, yeah.
For a limited time, update to a new car at Kevin Dennis Hyundai and get $2,000 cash back. Yes, update to a new XL Sprint and get $2,000 cash back. Plus, you'll get a better trade-in deal because Kevin Dennis is famous for the best trade-in deals in Melbourne. Hurry to Kevin Dennis Hyundai, 268 Ballarat Road, Sunshine, LMCT 175.
Update your car at Kevin Dennis. Update.
just off the ring road at the Western Highway exit.
Ever seen a big, fat zero? You have? Good. Because that's how much interest you pay in the first 3 months on personal finance at Advantage Credit Union. A big, fat zero. No interest for 3 months on personal finance at Advantage Credit Union. It's a great way to buy a computer, boat or caravan. Phone 13 11 40 for more information.
Conditions apply.
104.3 Gold FM. Complete news and information for Melbourne.
It's 9 degrees, more rain today, heading for a top of 12. Good morning, I'm Suzanne Northey with the 8 o'clock update. And now to a look at the traffic, here's Lucy in the sky.
Thanks, Suzanne. We've got a big power failure in the southern suburbs at the moment and the lights are all out about a 2 kilometre radius around the intersection of the Nepean Highway and South Road. Now, the Westgate Freeway, pretty slow going now from Grieve Parade. The Power Street exit is hovering between Clarendon Street and Kingsway. The rest aren't looking too tedious. Southeastern Freeway back to Toorak Road on the Tullamarine Freeway, you'll find it solid from Napier Street. The Eastern Freeway's queue is creeping back to the Chandler Highway overpass. The Nepean Highway 1 should be fine to get through the southern suburbs. It's very heavy through Elstonwick, but moving steadily. A couple of speed cameras out there too, and both in Glen Waverley on Camelot Drive and Highbury Road. And if you've got a sore throat this winter, help numb it with Mal Medithroat antiseptic lozenges for fast relief from pain and irritation. In cherry and mint flavours, you'll find them at your local supermarket. This is Lucy in the Sky, back with another Gold FM traffic update in 15 minutes.
More than 2.4 million workers will be paying the top tax rate unless the system is radically overhauled. New figures show one in three workers will be forced into the top rate within 3 years. The tax debate will heat up today when the Business Coalition for Tax Reform launches its Australians for Fairer Tax campaign. The health of patients and staff at the Royal Melbourne Hospital is being jeopardised by unhygienic conditions being blamed on funding cuts. Channel 7's Today Tonight will screen a secret camera investigation tonight, which shows dirty bedpans in open view, cigarette butts in a corridor and drip bags being left on chairs next to visitors. Pauline Hanson's apparently been sprung in a false travel claim, heading a list of backbench MPs who'd claimed extra cash for spending nights in Canberra. Figures obtained by the Herald Sun show Ms Hanson collected $14,000 in tax-free Canberra allowances in the second half of last year, more than any other MP. Ms Hanson says she's since repaid the money. Homebuyers looking for a change of scenery may like to consider Geelong. The city is offering an incentive package to encourage new residents. The freebies include $1,000 towards furniture removal, $5,000 worth of shopping vouchers and a year's membership to the Geelong Footy Club. And Premier Jeff Kennett's put his backing in place.
It's a wonderful example of how down here in Geelong, this community, as the Mayor said, is trying to populate its community. Come here and settle, grow the community and to meet the new opportunities.
A woman's been robbed of her wedding savings as she was getting off a tram in Preston last night. A teenager armed with a knife stopped her and demanded money. Unfortunately, the woman was carrying $400 she'd saved to pay for wedding photos. To Gold FM Sport now, and good morning to Tony Jones. Yes, good morning. And just when the US Golf Open was becoming a giant yawn, up bobs Lee Jansen. He's closing in on Payne Stewart and is now just two behind after 12 holes. Stewart is now on the 11th, looking to fend off the challenge. In fact, only moments ago, he sunk a giant putt to save par there. So the pressure's right on now, and we'll keep you updated throughout the morning. But just repeating, Payne Stewart now only two ahead, Lee Jansen closing in. Well, Pat Rafter's had a much-needed win in the lead-up to Wimbledon. He's defeated Martin Dam to win the final of the Heineken Open in the Netherlands. 7-6, 6-2 was the final scoreline. And with Wimbledon beginning tonight, Mark Philippoussis is among the early starters. He has that tough match against the seventh-seeded Yevgeny Kafelnikov. To soccer's World Cup, and Argentina has scored a 5-0 win over Jamaica this morning, while Germany came back from 2-0 down to force a tie with Yugoslavia. And in the last of the matches today, Iran scored an upset 2-1 win over the United States. But as David Loudon tells us, there was more at stake than just a game of soccer.
It's been almost 20 years since the Iran hostage drama, but politics threatened to overshadow today's clash between Iran and the United States. The USA is the sworn enemy of the Iranian government, but the players showed the world the two countries can at least bury the hatchet on a sporting level. As part of FIFA's Fair Play Day, both teams intermingled and posed for a joint team photo and exchanged gifts. A simple gesture, but in terms of world politics, a significant one. David Loudon in France covering the World Cup.
Footy now, and Melbourne ruckman Jim Steins will be off to a specialist this morning to determine the full extent of a knee injury suffered during yesterday's 85-point loss to St Kilda. Steins is facing up to 6 weeks on the sidelines, and the Dees can ill afford to lose him. They've now slipped out of the eight. Geelong has snuck in on percentage. Leading the way, though, is the Western Bulldogs, who are just ahead of St Kilda, and in a promoter's dream, those two will clash at Waverley this coming Saturday. The Bulldogs and the Saints at Waverley on Saturday. What a game that'll be. That's Gold FM Sport, with thanks to Clive Peters Superstores.
To finance now, and here's Peter Switzer from the Business Australian.
Interest rate worries. The pressure is still on, with the Japanese not coming up with any new big promises to fix its economy and currency at this weekend's G7 meeting. Our dollar started at 61.45 US cents, but is down to 61 US cents, and financial markets could test the dollar and yen today. However, the Japanese have promised to make a new statement on its reform plans on July 8. Meantime, gold will help the dollar, rising up to 296.75 US dollars an ounce, but Wall Street fell 100 points to 8713. This won't help the TAV float, which kicks off today.
The 104.3 Gold FM 4-day forecast, brought to you by Hyundai's XL Sprint. Cloudy with rain at times and showers this afternoon, a top of 12 degrees. Tomorrow, wet and cloudy again, still 12 degrees. Showers for Wednesday, a little warmer though, 14 degrees. And more rain for Thursday, still around the 14 degree mark. Right now in town, it's 9 degrees, and that's news, sport and information up to the minute on 104.3 Melbourne's Gold FM.
Eleven minutes after eight on Gold FM, good times and nothing but great songs. Oh, did you want to do it, Colette?
I wanted to do
I'm sorry, away you go. I'll start
do
it
I have
again.
Do I have to do the whole bit?
Yes, you do. It's 12 minutes after eight. Go.
You're listening to Gold FM 104.3, good times and nothing but great songs from the 60s, 70s and 80s. See, I'm still doing it with feeling.
Yes, you are. We've been listening in here in the break to some great songs from the 50s and 60s that belong to the wonderful voice of Frank Sinatra. And very soon in Melbourne, from July the 10th, there will be a show opening about Frank Sinatra called Simply Frank, and it stars our very next guest. Would you welcome Mr. Tom Burlinson?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Tom. What's happened? Oh, this delayed reaction for you.
They were stunned, our audience.
Now, thank you for coming down, because I understand you've come down from Sydney specifically to do this show.
You're the first.
Now, you've got a day full of publicity, have you?
Yeah.
Okay, well, good on you, mate. Now, where did you get the idea for this show?
Oh, that's a long time in my mind. I've been a Sinatra fan since I was a kid. And in my late teens, I really became an avid fan and bought record after record and would sing along with Frank. But it was really for my own enjoyment, Frank. Mm. And then more recently, I sang the voice of the young Sinatra in the miniseries that was made in Hollywood.
And you were great too. Thanks. I just saw it recently on Foxtel again.
And that actually, when that happened, when the news got back to here that you were going to do the voice, do you know what the reaction back here was?
What?
No, lots of people said, oh, we didn't even know he could sing.
No, well, that was the case at the time. But, you know, nobody even knew I could sing, let alone sing like Frank Sinatra.
We knew you could ride a horse, though.
That's right. And the reaction from people in America, when they'd ask Tina Sinatra, who produced the show, you know, who's singing the voice of Frank, and she'd say it's an Australian actor, Tom Burlinson, and they'd say, the kid on the horse.
did you know at that stage that you could sing well enough to pull that off?
Well, I didn't know whether it was well enough, but I sang for Tina, and she got tears in her eyes and said, you're the guy. And so, well, I guess that kind of gives it credibility, doesn't it?
Tom, can you sing like anybody else? Like, could you sing like Frank Holden?
Oh, I'd have to listen closely.
That's being but a bit.
But I do have a decent ear for imitation. Yes, I do. But Frank's something else, because my voice is in a similar range to his and with a similar tone, and because I love the style so much, I have imitated it for years. So,
who else did they audition for that performance?
I don't know. Everybody was talking about Harry Connick, but apparently. The old man didn't want Harry Connick, so...
So the use of yourself, that had to get the approval of Frank himself?
I would imagine so. I'm not exactly sure about that, but I don't think much goes past him. Well, went past him.
Did you get to meet him?
No, I asked because Tina arranged that I could go to Vegas and see her dad perform as his guest, and boy, did I love walking in there and saying, I'm a guest of Mr. Sinatra.
Yeah.
But And so I couldn't let the opportunity pass by, and I said, is there any chance of meeting your old man after the show? And she said, none, Tom. He doesn't meet anybody anymore. So I thought, okay.
Isn't that sad?
Did you call him your old man?
Yeah,
is that the terminology you use?
Well, I think he was pretty old by then.
I know, but is that the terminology you should be referring to? A show business legend.
I know, but Tina and I, you know, we were working very closely together in the studio, of course, because she was very hands-on producer. And,
Where did she have her hands on you?
Now. No. It was all right.
Now we're finding out how he did get the job.
Yes.
I think it's a good idea not to actually meet your idols sometimes.
Really? Do you think you might have been disappointed?
Well, depending on the mood he was in at the time, maybe.
Yeah.
I remember when I met Tony Barber.
Yes, it must have been very disappointing for you. Adriana Exenides was my nadir, really. There's a woman that I'd looked up to for years, and then when I first met her, you know, the first thing she said to me?
What?
Get out of my way.
Oh, dear.
Which is a very good cue for a Frank Sinatra song, My Way. Have you got that queued up, Jono?
No, he's... it's this one.
This is for Darren Hinch, really. That's life. Frank Sinatra.
That's life.
He's champing at the bit to burst into song. It's 20 after 8 and we are, of course, talking to Tom Berlinson, who is bringing to Melbourne a show called Frank, the Frank Sinatra Story in Song. It opens at the Comedy Theatre from July the 10th and we do have some passes to give away. So if you'd like to come along and see the show, it's been a huge success in Sydney and is sure to be a big success here in Melbourne. Ring this number, 94141043, and what you have to do is give us your take on Frank Sinatra. If you can sing a Frank Sinatra song or a piece thereof, then you could be off to see the show. 94141043, here's the traffic.
Gold FM, up to the minute traffic. Here's Lucy in the sky.
Look, off our power failure in the southern suburbs, and basically the lights are out at a particular bit of radius around the intersection of the Nepean Highway and South Road. Also, a bit of a kerfuffle on the Westgate Freeway at the moment. Actually, just about as you get onto the Williamstown inbound on-ramp, a car has come to grief, but two lanes can still get through, so it's not that bad. Basically, it's very heavy and slow in from the Western Ring Road interchange. Tullamarine Freeway has come to the crunch from Buller Road. Southeast is backed up to Toorak Road. The Eastern Freeway has a very heavy pocket around Bulleen Road and back to the Chandler Highway overpass. The Nepean Highway slow going now into town from Bentley. Couple of speed cameras out. Well, they're both in Glen Waverley. That's on Camelot Drive and Highbury Road. And every day, the NRMA helps more Australians with their cars and homes than any other company. Call NRMA for HELP on 132 132. This is Lucy in the Sky. Back with another Gold FM traffic update in 15 minutes.
This little old beef
McDonald's McFeast Deluxe. It's a bit saucy.
Make note of the temperature, because Peninsula Curtains' June Marathon Celsius sale is on now, with big savings on all window furnishings. Whatever the day's temperature, that's the discount you get. For instance, if it's 18 degrees, you'll get an 18% discount. Plus, if you order on the day they measure and quote, you'll get a further 5% discount. The June Marathon Celsius sale is on now. So watch the mercury this month and call Peninsula Curtains. 9888 7600. 9888 7600.
Whoa! Navigator, I want to get to the Hilton Hotel. Now, right now, I'm coming out of the airport. How do I get there? Uh-huh. Yeah, first ramp onto the freeway. Okay. Get on the left lane. Uh-huh. Yeah, and take the fourth exit. Oh, yeah, I'm talking to the taxi driver. He doesn't know his way around. He's driving on the wrong side of the road.
Vodafone Navigator gives you street directions over your mobile. Network Vodafone.
Oh, yeah!
Navigator available in all capital cities and some major regional centres.
Hello, Mr. Muffler. Rodney speaking.
Hi, are you the guys with a lifetime muffler guarantee?
That's us. Once you purchase your new lifetime muffler from Mr. Muffler, all replacement mufflers are free while you own the car.
So I only have to pay for a muffler once?
You got it.
So if my friends needed a new muffler, how can they find you?
Well, we have 11 stores across Melbourne and they're listed on page 1946 of the White Pages.
Does Mr. Muffler also do brakes and shockers?
We do, and we'll inspect them for free.
Ah, so if Mr. Muffler does mufflers, brakes and shockers, shouldn't you be called Mr. Muffler Brake Shockers?
24 after 8, and we are looking for some people who can do Frank Sinatra.
Oh, sorry.
also looking for a co-host who can keep her headphones on. What were you doing?
Oh, well, I just got sort of carried away. I was doing some drawing and then I realised we were on and, you know, it was a bit difficult.
Well,
but anyway.
We have some callers ready to display their vocal talents to Melbourne, and Tom will be the judge.
Oh, will he?
The winner will be going to see the show Frank, the Sinatra Story in Song from July 10th at the Comedy Theatre. Bill, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Hi, Bill. Are you American?
I am American.
Okay, let's hear it.
What do you want me to sing, anything?
You sing anything you like.
That's life, well, that's what people say. I'm riding high in the brawl, I'm shot down in May.
Thanks, Bill. Thanks, Bill.
Bill,
don't
give up your day job.
Now, I think Bill's got he's got a bit of an advantage having the American accent. So let's start off, Tom. Give Bill a score out of 10.
Oh, dear.
Just to be the base.
He's the base?
He will be the one that you will judge all the others upon, so just because he's the first.
Five
out of 10, Bill.
He couldn't even get it to his lips.
Patrick, are you there, Patrick?
Yeah, good morning, guys.
You're obviously a big Frank Sinatra fan.
Oh, I love him,
Okay, oh, let's see what you got.
For once in my life, I want someone who needs me.
Very good, Patrick.
Oh, Patrick.
The judges...
Oh, he gets the big
decision.
7 for that.
Seven out of 10. Well done, Patrick. Diane, are you there?
Hi, Frankie.
How are you this morning?
Thank you.
You're going to try and sound like Frank Sinatra, eh?
Oh, I don't know about that.
It's going to be a bit of a stretch, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Okay, Brian, let's hear your Frank Sinatra song.
Okay, start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York.
Oh, nice key change there.
If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you. New York.
Oh,
big finish.
Diane.
Oh, yeah.
Diane,
you got an extra point for the last note there, Diane.
That brings you up to 2.
6.5?
6.5.
Okay.
I think that would have been 10, except I think Diane sounded more like Shirley Temple than Frank Sinatra. Thanks, Diane. Marianne, are you there?
Oh, Marianne's gone.
Chickened out because
of harsh judgment, maybe.
Are you there, Marianne? No, Marianne's gone. Is Kelly there?
Yes, I'm here.
Hi, Kelly. How are you this morning?
Kelly, you sound so bushy-tailed.
I've had my coffee.
Oh, good.
Let's hear your Frank Sinatra, Kelly.
Sure. She gets too hungry for dinner at 8. She likes the dinner, but she never comes late. She never bothers with people she hates. That's why the lady is a tramp.
Yay, well done.
Hell.
Very good.
Well, Kelly sang for a lot longer than Patrick did.
Yes.
Patrick only sang for a short minute, didn't he?
Yes, he did. Well, come on, make up your mind. It's your decision, and you are the people...
Oh, I think Kelly was the best singer of the lot.
Cool!
You think so?
Oh, cool,
yeah.
She said.
Kelly, you have won.
Oh, great, that's terrific.
Congratulations.
Oh, excellent.
We will be giving more away. We can give it to everyone. Emma is writing. Why don't you just tell me?
Oh, good. Well, everybody thinks it, so you're all going to ticket.
Everyone's
that's
great.
But Kelly, you actually won. Even though they're all getting a ticket, you actually won.
Oh, thanks.
But Marianne isn't getting a ticket because she chickened out, huh?
Exactly.
Oh. Absolutely.
Oh, well. All right.
So, Kelly, you'll be going along to the Comedy Theatre. The show starts from July the 10th. And possibly because she's the winner, Tom, we could organise for her to meet you after the
oh,
show.
Sure. Absolutely.
Would that be all right?
Oh, terrific.
Would you like that, Kelly?
Yeah, I'd love it. Thank you.
Okay, so all of our callers will be getting a double pass to go and see Frank, the Sinatra Story in Song. And in honour of Frank, we're paying some reach points. It's 29 after 8. Here's news with Dennis O'Connell on Gold FM.
Recent scientific tests have proven a long, hard day at work can often result in nausea, stress, tiredness, and irritability. These tests also found that singing along to your favourite songs gradually helped ease those symptoms. So, that's why on Gold FM, we make sure you know every song we play, like these. No way. And these. And you definitely know these.
You come from a land down under.
This is rock and roll.
And these.
There she was.
Just walking down the street,
you can go. Gold FM is the station you can listen to most at work. For good times and nothing but great songs from the 60s, 70s and 80s. 104.3, Gold FM.
Tickets! Everyone, go for the Tats Keno Weekly tickets!
What about you, madam?
Mm?
Got your Tats Keno Weekly ticket?
You can win $1 million a day.
Ooh, I'll take one, thanks.
And you, sir, have you got your Tats Keno Weekly ticket? Good. That's what I like to see. You don't want to miss out on $1 million a day.
With a Tats Keno Weekly ticket, every day is $1 million day. You get 7 spot 10 games for 7 days.
Next stop, your local Tats Lotto outpost.
Don't you just hate winter? You come home and the house is freezing. What you need is heat, and you want it fast. You want the fastest oil heater around, the Heat Machine. It's 3 times faster than traditional oil heaters. The Heat Machine from DeLonghi. We were thinking of you when we thought of it.
Now then, if I could just...
Take down your name, sir.
Yes, Fairweather Wallace L.
Thank you. And your phone number?
Oh, no, you don't need that. I'm not actually interested in buying this marvellous property. I just like having a sticky beak around other people's homes when they're open for inspection. Oh, what a splendid piano. Would you care to Wallace?
Mr. Fairweather.
Ow! Ooh.
If you don't mind, this inspection is for serious buyers.
Well, if they're serious about matters domestic, they can't go past NRMA Home and Contents Insurance. Did you know that NRMA now has rating 1 for home insurance?
No, I did not know that.
Which means you're entitled to a 25% discount if you haven't made a claim in the past 12 months.
Thank you for that fascinating discourse on insurance, yeah. But I'm afraid we really are out of time.
Oh, what a pity. I was hoping you'd join me for a duet. You've left me one good hand. Do you know the bottom to chopsticks? Come on, sit next to me and... Ow! Oh, well, now you're on your own. Do you take requests?
For a rating 1 on home insurance, call NRMA anytime on 132 132. 104.3 Gold FM. Complete.